Hello guys, welcome to another video. In this video, we are going to study about thoracic vertebrae in the topic bones and joints of thorax. So before starting the video, please make sure that you all guys have subscribed to my channel and also press the notification bell button. So let's start this topic. Thoracic vertebrae. What is the characteristic feature or what is the main feature by that we will identify that this is the thoracic vertebrae? So on each side, left side as well as right side of the body of thoracic vertebrae, you will see there will be articular facets. The facets can be demi-facet, that is half or semi-facet, or the facets can be full facets. So remember this thing, if on the side of the body, on the side of body of vertebrae, if you see articular facets, then that vertebra will be thoracic vertebra only. So as you can see in this diagram, this quadrilateral shaped part of the vertebrae, this is the body of vertebrae. And on the side of body of vertebrae, on each side, you can see these facets. And these facets will be seen on right side as well as left side of the body. And here in this diagram, these facets are demi-facets. As you can see, these are not full facets. So you will see these facets on right side of the body also. And when you will turn it, you will see these facets on left side of body also. So if you see these type of articular facets on the body of vertebra, that means you are very sure that it is only the thoracic vertebra. These type of articular facets you will not find in cervical, lumbar or sacral vertebra. You will not see these type of facets. And these are the only facets where the ribs will be attached of thoracic wall. Now the thoracic vertebra are also classified into two groups, that is typical thoracic vertebra and atypical thoracic vertebra. Typical thoracic vertebra are 2nd to 8th and atypical thoracic vertebra are 1st, 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th. You have to just remember that 2nd to 8th thoracic vertebra are typical thoracic vertebra, and typical thoracic vertebra means these all vertebra have same general features. And atypical thoracic vertebra means these vertebras have some special features, and each vertebra will have different or something, some special features. So first will have special features, every vertebra will have different special features, but 2nd to 8th vertebra, all these vertebra have same features. That's why they are known as typical, and these are known as atypical thoracic vertebra. And here one important thing you should know is in the typical thoracic vertebra, you will see only demi-facets, that is half facets. And in atypical vertebra, you can see demi-facets also and full facets also. But always in typical thoracic vertebra, you will see only half facets or demi-facets on the side of the body. Now we will see in detail about the typical thoracic vertebra. And here we have to mainly know about the typical thoracic vertebrae, when we have to remember these things. And atypical thoracic vertebra are not important. You don't have to remember all the features of atypical thoracic vertebrae. You just have to know about the typical thoracic vertebrae. These are only asked in exam or practical exams or in viva. So always typical thoracic vertebra have two parts. One is body and another is vertebral arch. And between the body and vertebral arch of thoracic vertebra, you will see a circular canal that is known as vertebral canal. And that canal you will see the spinal cord, which is surrounded by its meninges. As you can see here in this diagram, this part of vertebra is the body of vertebra, and this whole backward or posterior part of vertebra, this part is vertebral arch of vertebra. And as you can see, between the body of vertebra and between the body of vertebra and vertebral arch of vertebra, you will see this foramen, this circular foramen. This is vertebral foramen, or you can say vertebral canal. Between this or inside this foramen, you are seeing the spinal cord. There, here the spinal cord will be present along with its meninges. So spinal cord is present here between these two parts of the thoracic vertebra or all the vertebras. And like this, vertebra also give protection to the spinal cord. Now let's study about the first part of the typical thoracic vertebra, that is body. In typical or normal thoracic vertebra, typical thoracic vertebra, you will see the shape of the body will be heart shaped, and anteroposterior and transverse dimensions will be almost equal. So as you can see here in this diagram, the body of vertebra will be heart shaped. As you can see here, the thoracic vertebra will be heart shaped, and anteroposterior, this is the anteroposterior diameter and this is the transverse diameter. So as you can see here, this anteroposterior diameter and this transverse diameter are almost equal, and these equal diameters are seen only in thoracic vertebra. So when you will find that anteroposterior and transverse diameter are equal, that is the typical thoracic vertebra. In thoracic vertebra only you will see that these dimensions are equal. And as I told you, on each side of the body you will see the costal facets or articular facets. The costal facets, the name is given because costal means ribs. So ribs are attached on the facets of the body of vertebra, that's why they are also known as costal facets. And as I told you before, the facets you will see in the typical thoracic vertebra are only demifacets, not full facets. Demifacets are only seen in typical thoracic vertebra. So you will see two facets on each side of the body. Two will be present on right side, two will be present on left side. And the superior facet will be the larger facet, which is present near the superior border of body. And it articulates with the same number of rib. And inferior facet will be smaller in size, and it will be present near the inferior border of the body, and it will articulate with the head of next lower rib. Means superior facet will be articulate with same number of rib, and inferior facet will articulate with lower, that is next lower rib. Let me explain you this. So here in this diagram you can see on side of vertebra, on each side there will be two facets. On another side also you will see these type of two facets. And you can see this is half facet or demifacet, and this is also demifacet. That means it is, this is the diagram of typical thoracic vertebra. This is a superior costal facet, which is, you can see, is larger than inferior costal facet, and it is present near the superior border of the body. And this is the inferior costal facet, which is present near the inferior border of the body, and you can see this is small in size as compared to superior costal facet. So let's assume this is a T4 vertebra, that is fourth thoracic vertebra. So head of fourth rib will be attached to superior costal facet of T4 vertebra, and head of fifth rib will be attached to inferior costal facet of T4 vertebra. So as you can see, on superior costal facet the number is same. Here will be fourth rib will be attached to T4 vertebra, and here fifth rib will be attached to T4 vertebra. Fourth rib, fourth vertebra, but here fifth rib, fourth vertebra. Let's assume that this rib you are seeing here is a fourth rib, and this is fourth vertebra, T4, that is fourth thoracic vertebra, and this is T3 vertebra, that is third thoracic vertebra. So as you all know, here on the sides of the body, here will be superior articular facet, and here will be inferior articular facet of fourth thoracic vertebra. Here will be superior articular facet, and here will be inferior articular facet of third thoracic vertebra. So as you will see, half part of the head of fourth rib will articulate with superior articular facet of T4 vertebra, and half part of head of fourth rib will articulate with inferior costal facet of T3 vertebra. So rib does not articulate only to single vertebra, but in fact rib articulates with two vertebras. So half part of rib will articulate with superior costal facet of T4 vertebra and half part of rib will articulate with inferior costal facet of T3 vertebra. Here it is third thoracic vertebra and on inferior costal facet T4 vertebra, T4 rib is attached. And here it is superior costal facet of T4 vertebra and here fourth rib is attached. So as I told you, on inferior costal facet on T3 vertebra, fourth rib will be attached, that is different number, and on superior costal facet of T4 vertebra, that is fourth vertebra, fourth rib will be attached, on that is 4-4 same number. So remember this, if you will understand it, it will be very easy. Now let's study about another part of typical thoracic vertebra, that is vertebral arch. Vertebral arch is made up of different parts, that is pedicles, lamina, spinous process, two transverse process and two paired articular processes, which may be superior articular processes or inferior articular processes. So in the vertebral arch, the anterior most part here, both pairs, these will be pedicle, and again further it will be continued as lamina. This is lamina. So here it will be pedicle on both sides and here it will be lamina on both sides. And posteriorly, both lamina fuse together in the midline to form a process that is known as spinous process. And laterally on both sides, you will see one process. Laterally, these are the two transverse processes which will present on the junction of pedicle and lamina. So these are the two transverse processes. And you will also see paired articular processes. So here you can see these are the superior articular processes and these here are the inferior articular processes. So two superior articular processes present on upward side and two inferior articular processes present on downward side. So just remember all the parts of the vertebral arch, that is these two will be pedicles, which are again known as further lamina. Lamina fuse to form spinous process. Laterally you have left side as well as right side you have two transverse processes, and upward side you will see two superior articular processes and downward side you will see two inferior articular processes. And you will also see that the superior vertical notch will be shallow in thoracic vertebra and inferior vertebral notch will be deep. Why? What is the reason for this? As you can see here in this diagram, this notch, which is very shallow, this is the superior vertebral notch, and this notch, which is very, very deep, this is the inferior vertebral notch of thoracic vertebra. And you will see generally in typical thoracic vertebras, this inferior vertebral notch will be deep and superior vertebral notch will be very shallow. Why it is shallow? Superior vertebral notch, why it is shallow? As I told you, the part of vertebral arch which arises from body will be known as pedicle. And as you can see here in this diagram, the pedicle is arising from superior border of the body more than inferior border of the body. So when it arises from superior border of the body, you will see that it arises from upwards more than downwards, that it is not arising on middle part of the body of vertebra. That's why inferior vertebral notch is very deep and the superior vertebral notch is very shallow, because it is arising from near or more near to the superior border of the body. That's the reason that inferior vertebral notch is deep and superior vertebral notch is shallow. And these spinous processes will be present backwards and these will be oriented downwards. As you can see here, this is the vertebra or vertebral column. Here you can see the spinous processes are present on the back side. So these are known as to present on the back side, so backwards, and these are directed and these are oriented. As you can see, these are not vertical, these are directed downwards. So these are present on back side, so backwards, and directed downwards, so these are directed downwards. And the superior articular process of one vertebrae will articulate with inferior articular processes of above vertebrae, and inferior articular process of one vertebrae articulate with superior articular process of vertebra below. Let me explain this to you. That is, if let's assume that this is a T6 vertebra. So superior articular processes of T6 vertebra articulate with inferior articular processes of T5 vertebra. Very simple. And the inferior articular processes of T6 vertebra articulate with superior articular processes of T7 vertebra. So superior articular processes articulate with inferior articular processes of vertebra above, and inferior articular processes articulate with superior articular processes of vertebra below. And let me tell you, inferior vertebral notch of one vertebra completes one whole circular foramen with superior vertebral notch of lower vertebra, and then form an intervertebral foramen, and through this foramen the spinal nerves passes, which arising from the spinal cord, which is present in vertebral canal. So this is the inferior vertebral notch of T2 vertebra, and this is the superior vertebral notch of T3 vertebra. In real, these two vertebra will be present close, and it will in turn complete this circus or this circle. Sorry, this one complete turn in turn. It completes this circle. This is known as intervertebral foramen because it is present between two vertebras. And through this intervertebral foramen, spinal nerves like T1, T2, T3 spinal nerves will be come out, which are emerging from the spinal cord. So as I told you, between the body of vertebra and vertebral arch, there will be a vertebral canal in which there will be present a spinal cord. From spinal cord, spinal nerves will arise. These nerves will come out through this intervertebral foramen, which is formed by superior articular notch of lower vertebra and inferior vertebral notch. So intervertebral foramen is formed by the superior vertebral notch of lower vertebra and inferior vertebral notch of above vertebra, and then from this intervertebral foramen, spinal nerves will come out, which are arising from the spinal cord. Very, very simple. And the facet, one facet also present on the tip of transverse process, which articulates with the tubercle of same number of rib. As I told you, when we studied about the osteology of ribs, on the posterior end of rib we have one tubercle, which is known as the tubercle of rib. So this is the tubercle of rib, and this is the transverse process, and on the tip of transverse process there will be a present of one facet which will articulate with the tubercle of rib. So the facets present on tip of transverse process will articulate with tubercle of rib. And remember, if this is a third rib, this will be the third thoracic vertebra. That is, tubercle of third rib will articulate only with the tip of transverse process of third thoracic vertebra. That is, the number is same here. So third rib tubercle will be articulate with third thoracic vertebra transverse process facet. So two demi facets present on each side of the body, and one demi facet or maybe a full facet present on the tip of transverse process of thoracic vertebra of same number, that is third thoracic vertebra, will articulate with tubercle of third rib. So that's all about the topic thoracic vertebra. Here we have completed the topic of thoracic vertebrae. And after this osteology of thoracic vertebra, we will see about the joints of, that is, different joints present in the thorax. I hope guys you like this video. And if you really like this video, please subscribe to my channel and also press the notification bell button so you will not miss any update from the channel. And also give a like to the video and also share these type of video lectures or videos present on my channel to your friends which are doing MBBS. And if you wanna see video lectures related or to MBBS or video lectures like this, you can see more videos like this on my channel. So that's all for today's video. I will meet you in the next video. Till then, thank you so much for watching this video.